So these are the glimpses where the spirit felt information from the villagers, and legally itself they segregated the matters, and accordingly social issues and legal issues segregated. Legal issues are forwarded to the advocates, those who are on panel of our legal itself. Then another suggestion that is to tie with the local history of economics, concerning economic and law subjects. So memorandum of understanding was signed between this college and certificate course in law and economics that we have started. ENSS program, that these are the results of the ENSS. 50 units we have granted by the university. This is another output, that is suggestion to organize a workshop on Muslim personal law and propose recommendations. The object behind it, that is to study and discuss the present Muslim personal law and propose recommendations. Accordingly, the invitation was sent. Advocate Bhaskar Rao Award was a senior advocate, who was called. Then Vaidhi Joshi, Madam Principal, Alice Law College, she was also invited. Jaya Sangrabar, who major contributed, she was also invited. And Dr. Samshuddin Tambodi, who is the president of Muslim Satishodhak Mandal. So these are the glimpses.
Okay, now
then
two questions we have to ask. How much you have completed now?
Still there?
Yes, still.
How much time?
Only 5 minutes, sir. I will finish straight up.
Okay. Sir. Then again, list that we have subscribed. Then these are the major contributions. Then in 18 and 19, suggestion was to conduct induction program for the placement cell, and accordingly induction program was conducted. Second, that is to start a new program, that is judicial activism and legal intervention. The idea is that the students should be exposed in practical, that is in real court, and hence with the association of Advocate Asim Sarvade, we started a new program, that is judicial activism and legal intervention. And the result is 11 students, they participated, they presented a suit on different social issues, and that suits are disposed of in Mahalok Adalat also. The, we can see, so these are the glimpses. Second, that is parent-teacher meeting. A plagiarism software that is suggested by the library member, and accordingly college has taken initiative and purchased it, and that color printer and watercolor, that is for the infrastructure. So these are the till today suggestions such by the IPSC, and accordingly college implemented.
Sorry. Two questions to ask you.
Yes.
You are all committee members, then suggest or make recommendation or put up their views, whatever it is. One is, there are several committees, there are several associations, parent teachers meetings, societies, film society, all these things are. Have you got any rules and regulations framed for that, for those approved by your governing council? For all those committees, associations, societies.
A resolution has been passed by the management, and accordingly through this resolution we are implementing all these things.
So these are established by the management?
By the all the societies are not established by the management, but the IPSC cell, that is through the resolution we have started it.
No, IPSC cell is one thing. Whether these societies, this film society, Mukkot Association, placement cell, parent teachers association, are they established by a particular rules and regulations? My question is very simple.
Not in that way as you say, but
this IQAC unit is formed by the resolution by the manager. We all are members, so we meet twice in a year, most probably those who are available. We discuss on it. We record the minutes, and those minutes are signed by everyone. So those minutes are also attached, I think, in one file. So we are not making any resolutions, but through minutes we are recording all these things. That yes, we have formed Mukkot Society, we have formed Film Society. So minutes are available.
So this management has formed.
This management representative is there.
Correct. So rules and regulations framed by the management is correct.
In respect of film society and other associations, that is, college has decided college is implemented.
The IQAC's establishment is with the approval of the management.
Management.
And the parameters are also approved by the management.
By the management.
Management.
So management has formed this.
The rest of the committees which are functioning are with the resolution of the committee of the IQAC, which is regulated by the principal.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Correct.
Number two. Now, this IQAC was established when?
2015.
First June 2015.
2015.
Yes.
2015.
Yes.
We are in now 2018.
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Say 2017. During the last 2 years, any best practices were suggested by your IQAC, sir?
Center for Advanced Legal Research.
Yes.
Center for Advanced Legal Research and Training. We have established that center, sir. I have presented it in my presentation also, and we have done it with Advocate Abhangar Prasad. So it is our institution's one best practice also, and it came to IQAC.
Anything you have discussed on student scholarship in IQAC?
No, that is led by the students. I am not taken. Just only major contributions I have taken in the IQAC presentation. So this kind of scholarship I am not taken.
Reason is that institutional scholarship is already in our system even before the establishment of IQAC.
And we are dealing with social welfare department for scholarship. So compulsory certain norms and regulations related to social welfare department we have to follow.
So one best practices according to you is
Center for Advanced.
Any other is there?
Another thing in which I told you, the management has registered a request to the principal to set up a family counseling center.
Family counseling center.
Yes. Sir, and I must share one thing I want to tell, sir. Sir got retired in 2012, and since 2013 he is working with us continuously for 5 years, and every so every Tuesday and Friday
for good health of the society also.
No cases are not there, he'll come, he'll sit here, he'll ask us, madam kuch hai kya, otherwise he'll go. So he's taking so much initiative, and he's really
madam, you pardon my saying, you will find this dedication with most of this generation. With the coming generation, their dedication is decreasing. No, to the younger.
Accept.
Can you give us a copy of your college prospectus?
Yes.
I have seen that.
The management also request, suggest in the IQAC meeting that more and more High Court judges, Supreme Court judges, or the eminent judges working in High Court and Supreme, they should be invited to guide.
You have invited Uday Umesh Lalit, you have invited Anil Dave, you have invited
Swatantra Kumar.
Yes, Swatantra Kumar.
Chalmeshwar also.
Contribution of IQAC in the overall development, we are interested. Yeah. Position is best, no problem. No worry at all. We have noted
in your absence, we have also given a request to the principal that 3 more candidates are ready to take admission.
That will be excellent. And what I was telling is that since many of the students are coming from rural area, in some particularly in law. So their English also.
Immediate classes you are holding it. Disha?
Yeah,
Disha.
Great, sir. We are not sleeping.
Another thing is that the separate counselor is appointed.
Huh? The counselor? Yeah. Yeah, she is sitting.
Yeah.
I can tell you, sir. You have made 45 minutes each presentation, 45 minutes we can also make. Thank you very much. Just a minute. If you have any one of you particular suggestion to the peer team, or most of any suggestion you would like to give to the peer team.
Sir, one member I forgot. He is Dr. M. D. Lawrence, sir. He is principal of Commerce College, Sister Concern.
Of your
MMCC, Marathwada Vidyamandir Commerce College. He is principal.
In one sentence, I'll just note myself. That we as management, we try to bridge the gap between theory and practice. That we have to talk about.
That we have seen the practical orientation in your theoretically we have seen. Practically we would be moving along. We will also like to see where very much.
So can I ask a question?
Please.
Basically,
question to whom? To me.
To all of you, basically, that's your team. So what we have seen is you have certain standards like criteria 5 and everything, and then we follow that. But being a counselor, it's really disturbing to see that, you know, when we see that does the college have a way of delineating or differentiating between slow learners and students who are doing well. So slow learners is something which brings to mind, you know, students who are at a very low level, let's say first grade or second grade, that is when it is actually identified. So seeing that at the college level for me, it's very disturbing to kind of, you know, kind of differentiate on those levels. If you could, I mean, if NAC could have a different way of defining, you know, maybe students who are lagging behind rather than calling them, you know, slow learners. So that was something which was really something that struck me.
I appreciate your concern as a psychologist, and let me say a few words in this regard. Probably, we both at least come from the national law universities, and in 2016, when I held the All India Common Law Admission Test, we changed the nomenclature from physically disabled or disabled people to specially able persons. You see our prospectus, the word disabled or physically disabled does not appear. The reservation is also for specially abled person, SAP. So we consider them as specially abled person because in spite of their handicap, still they are coming, trying to come into the mainstream of the society. So that kind of awareness is there. You will be there, putting dress in the wall. Okay, the doctor was intelligent. Psychologist has to take a class for 2 to 3 hours. तो वो कहते तो अपने उसको पेशेंट को तो वो बोलते हैं पेशेंट को खराब नहीं है डॉक्टर ही पागल है जिसको 3 घंटे तक पता ही नहीं चला अच्छा बना साइकोलॉजिस्ट और साइकेट्रिक का जो साइकेट्रिक का डॉक्टर है उसको हम पागल बना देते हैं जो पागल नहीं है दो पेशेंट भी पागल तो नहीं है लेकिन पेशेंट है उसको कहते पेशेंट तो ठीक है सो दैट इट इज अ वेरी नाउ वी आर चेंजिंग Now most of the institutions are having a counseling center. They have a psychologist, they have a psychiatrist. So it becomes very difficult to convince the parent to show your child to a psychiatrist. I don't know what is the position, but as a head of the institution, I have found it. I have been able to cure at least a dozen students, forcing the parents to send to the psychologist or a psychiatrist to their children. And they are doing very well now.
So in fact, as a contribution to ITAC, we are doing something called positive psychology. So what we've decided is students don't come, not just to a psychiatrist, even to a psychologist. So what we thought is why don't we just give them the skills, you know, whatever is needed, whether it's happiness, you know, how we can increase your level of happiness, research-based, or how we can actually work on stress management through meditation, mindfulness. So what we do is once a month, we kind of come together with students and then we talk to them about, you know, all these things. And so we're trying to take a proactive or developmental approach where let's give them the skills and then from that maybe they'll come to a counselor rather than a counselor just sitting in one corner and waiting for them to come which they'll never come because of pure, you know.
Even the peer pressure, you know, too much to pagal pagal doctor ke paas gaye. Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah, pagal khane mein gaye the, wo to ye kehte.
Yes, sir. So exactly. So we're giving it to all. So, you know, they are free to decide. And in fact, we found a lot of students coming to us, in fact, seeking counseling for parent also. You know, she WhatsApped me saying, ma'am, can you talk to my mom? And then we did talking with the mom because end of it, we are a society, you know, we are doing well for society, not just for students or anybody. Because, you know, if a student is happy, only the parents or the family unit is happy. So there we've seen a lot of changes in students coming. And this we've been practicing for the last 2 years, you know. So we have this consolidated, we call it personality curriculum. So I'll share the sheet with you also. But in that we kind of outline what are the different areas from a counselor's perspective that might be necessary for students, and then that is what they're trying to
provide. I don't want to name a vice chancellor. His daughter wrote a small sixth standard student wrote a letter to God. She was unhappy in the family or the education, so she wrote a letter to God. And the parents, even the vice chancellor and his wife, they were making a fun of it, and she has written a letter to God.
I read the letter and I said, if she needs immediately a psychiatric treatment. And now she is one of the brilliant girls. Brilliant girls. She had the call. Parents were there. Mother was busy in her job. Father was thinking, I'm a vice chancellor. So he is enjoying his power and status, and the child is ignored. She was being reared by only the servants. तभी तो कहते हैं जब बेड में बैठे होते हैं माँ अपने मोबाइल पे लगी होती है फादर अपने आईपैड पे लगा होता है तो बच्चा दोनों को देखते लगता है मैं तो ऊपर से ही टपका हूँ
Yeah. Good morning, sir. I'm Tushy Arora and I'm teaching arbitration to the fourth year BSc and legal theory for the Good morning, sir. Myself is Shubhangi Deshmukh. Since 2012, I'm working over here and this year I'm teaching accuracy to third year ELL.
Good morning, sir. I am Swapnil Sagne, working as assistant professor in law. So I am an NSS program officer here. I am teaching professional ethics, jurisprudence, and the criminal psychology subject. And I am presently pursuing my PhD from the Department of
Law. All the lawyers, they have given a call to go nationwide strike October.
Yes, sir.
Is it
actually ethical? It is against the professional ethics.
Is it ethical or unethical?
No, sir. Actually, as per professional ethics, it's unethical. But
good morning, myself Advocate Anagha Joshi. I am here as a visiting faculty. I do teach CPC. I am practicing lawyer for since 2005. I have also worked as a family court judge. So here I am teaching CPC.
The most difficult, then section, then order. I only know what order 6, rule 17.
Amen.
Good morning, sir. My name is Tanaya Naik. I work here as a visiting faculty and I'm teaching law science tech for second year LLM.
Law
science and technology.
Law, science and technology.
Yes.
Is there any relationship between them?
Yes, it does have. With the taking into consideration the emerging technologies like robotics, DNA.